Hello episodes. Today our topic is society, law and ethics, and this is unit number 5 of IP syllabus. And in this chapter we are going to discuss about intellectual property and intellectual property right. So let us take them one by one. First of all, intellectual property. So what is intellectual property? Intellectual property is the property created by the application of human mind. So any property which is created by the application of human mind is called the intellectual property. And intellectual property is a term referring to a number of distinct type of creations of the mind for which property rights are recognized for the corresponding fields of laws. And intellectual property is basically used for textiles, cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, machinery, books, etc. These all are the basically IP or intellectual property protected. So intellectual property is used for textiles, cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, machinery, books, etc. So it is a very simplest definition of intellectual property. Intellectual property is a property created by the application of human mind, such as any composition of music or any creative work, such as any artistic work, any painting. So these all are the basically intellectual properties. Now here it is a detailed definition of intellectual property. Intellectual property refers to the creation of mind. So the focus on the word here is creation of mind. And creation of minds basically includes inventions, literacy and artistic work, and symbols, names, images and designs used in commerce. And there are two basic categories of it. First one is industrial properties, which include invention, patents, trademark, industrial design, etc. And second is copyright, which includes literacy and artistic works. So we can say that intellectual property refers to the creation of the mind. And when we say that creation of mind, that includes invention, literacy and artistic work. And basically it is divided into two broad categories. First one is industrial property, which includes inventions. Basically we can say that patents or trademark or industrial design. And second is copyright, which include literacy and artistic works. So these are the different types of intellectual properties. So now, what is intellectual property right? Intellectual property right are the right for the intellectual properties for an author or a person. So intellectual property is the creation of the mind of an individual which has the commercial and moral value. Intellectual property right grants exclusive right to the author for utilizing for their creation. And utilizing and benefiting for their creation. And there are some types of intellectual properties here. These are patent, copyright, trademark. All of these all terms are very well known. And some of them are design, database and trade sheets. So in this lecture we are only going to discuss about these three important terms: patent, copyright and trademarks. And it may be asked in examination that what is the difference between patent or copyright, or what is patent or what is copyright or what is trademarks, or even it may be asked that what is intellectual property right, or what do you understand by the term intellectual property right. So intellectual property right is basically a creation of the minds of an individual, and which has a commercial and moral values. And intellectual property rights grants exclusive right to an author for utilizing and benefiting from their creation, whatever he or she create, such as a painting, or it may be a composition of a song. So all these are intellectual property rights. Now there are three important terms, as I told you earlier, that patent, copyright and trademark. So first of all, let us discuss them one by one. Patent, copyright and trademark. First term is copyright. As the name suggests, copyright. So a copyright protects someone who creates an original work. An original work can be a book, it may be a play or it may be a website or among others. The goal of copyright is to prevent unauthorized copying of your work. So a copyright protects someone who creates an original work, and when we say that original work, it may be a painting or it may be a composition of a song or it may be a book or it may be a play or it may be a website. So these all are the basically preserved by copyrights. Now there is a diagrammatic representation of copyright protects. What copyright protects? First is literacy, means regarding to books, and second is dramatic, any drama or play, musical, any composition of a song or any music composition, artistic, any painting, any architectural work. So these all are the copyright protects. Next is these all are the copyright protects. Now I think the definition is quite clear. So copyright protects someone who creates an original works, and when we say the original work, it means that it may be a book or it may be a play or it may be a website among others. So these all are the copyright protects. Now there is a small cartoon here, and it shows the licensing of a copyright, and here we can easily see that there is a small girl here and a small boy also here, and girl says to the boy that you can use my song called it is basically a song, and it is written or composed by this girl, and basically this girl give permission to this boy that he can use his song whatever it is. In this case it is OOA. So when a copyright owner gives permission to a particular party to use the copyrighted work for a specific reason, and that is called a licensing. Now there is a detailed definition of a copyright. Copyright allows authors, musicians, artists, etc. to make money off their labor. First point. Second point, it prevents others from taking their work for free. And third point, it also prevents people from altering the work without permission. So there are three important points. First one is basically copyright is used by authors, musician and artist, and they used to make money of their labor. This is first point. Second point is it prevent other from taking their work for free. It means if anybody want to use their work, then he or she can pay some money to him according to his choice or demand. And third point is it also prevent people from altering the work without permission. So no one can alter his or her work without his or her permission. So there are three important points regarding to copyright. So again I told you the definition. Copyright allows author, musicians, artist, etc. to make money off their labor. It prevents others from taking their work for free, and it also prevents people from altering the work without permission. Now second term, this is all about copyright. Second term is patent. So patent is an exclusive right granted by the authority to the applicant of an invention for a limited period of time. So this is very important, for a limited period of time. And person do some invention here, and there is an exclusive right for his invention, and this exclusive right basically a some limited period of time. So there are three important points here. First one is, there is an exclusive right here for a person, and this exclusive right is for a limited period of time. And it gives basically full disclosure of his invention. There are some other points regarding to patent. A patent is a property right granted to the inventor by the patent office. So it is basically provided by patent office to inventor, and it is a right to exclude others from the making, using, offering for sale or selling or importing the invention into the jurisdiction. And third point regarding to this is very important, limited by the term 17 to 20 years. So there is a time limit also, it is 17 to 20 years. The scope of the patent, so the jurisdiction and subject to the right of the other patent and agreements. And one issued patentee must enforce the rights. So there are a few important points. First of all, a patent is a property right guaranteed by the inventor by the patent office. So it is given by the patent office to inventor. That is the first important point. And second point is, it is a right to exclude other from making, using, offering and sale or selling. And third is time limit is 17 to 20 years. And last important thing, one issued patentee must enforce the rights. Now, third important point, trademark. To understand trademark, there is an example of Nike here, and here it is written that Nike, it is a symbol of Nike here and registered since 1971. And also there is a symbol of Coca-Cola here, and it also shows that it is registered since 1887. So what is a trademark? A trademark is basically a distinctive sign which identifies the goods and service of one company from those of another. So there are many companies in a particular field, and if one company want to identify himself, identify itself from others, then basically it use trademark. And using trademark, they can easily identify themselves uniquely. So basically it is a distinctive sign which identifies the goods and service of one company from those of another. Second thing is, a trademark helps consumer to identify and choose between product service based on their reputation and quality. And second purpose is for trademark is for consumer easily identify and select product on behalf of trademark of a particular product or a company. So there are few important points. First is, it is a distinctive sign. Second thing is it identified the goods and service from one company from the another, and it is also helpful for the customers to identify and choose between product and service based on their reputation. So what is trademark for, or what is trademark used for? A trademark basically identifies a company to the customer, first important thing. Second, customer knows the trademark and they have learned to trust that company makes good products. So that is third important point. So there are three important points regarding trademark. First is, a trademark identifies company to the customer. Second, customers knows that the trademark, and they have learned to trust that that company makes good products. So that is the basic purpose of trademark. And what is the difference between trademark, copyright and patent? There are few differences among them. So let us take them one by one. On the basis of the question, who it serves? For copyright, it is authors. They are authors. For patent, they are inventors. And for trademark, they are brands. So first important question, who it serves? Regarding to copyright, patent and trademark, for copyright they are authors, for patent they are investors, and for trademark they are brands. And what is the purpose of copyright, patent and trademark? Purpose of copyright is to protect original creative and intellectual work, and purpose of patent is to grant exclusive right to exploit an invention, and purpose of trademark is to distinguish product or service from competitors. Example of copyright is copyrights are music, art and photography. An example of patent are medical devices or technologies. An example of trademarks are words, logos, slogans, colors. Now the most important thing, the time limit. Time limit of a copyright is about 70 to 170 years. Time limit for inventors are 15 to 20 or 17 to 20 most of the time. And time limit for trademark is basically indefinite. And here we can easily say that as far as the difference is concerned, copyright is used for original or creative work or intellectual work. Patent is used for an invention, and trademark is basically used for products or service which distinguish others, it from others. And most important, time limit of copyright is 70 to 170 years. For patent it is 50 to 20 years, and for trademark it is indefinite. Now there are some other important points also regarding to copyright, patent and trademark. So there is a difference between copyright, patent and trademark. So let us take them one by one. Copyright in copyright protects expression, not ideas. That is the basic philosophy behind copyright. Copyright protect expressions, not ideas. And patent protect ideas that have been reduced to practice. And trademark protect goodwill associated with marks. So that is a very important point regarding to copyright, patent and trademark. Again I repeat you that copyright protects expression, not ideas. Patent protects ideas that have been reduced to practice, and trademark protect goodwill associated with mark. And if there is a single line difference, if you want to write single line difference between copyright, patent and trademark, so this is the line: use of copyright, patent and trademark. And second is time limit. Time limit is already discussed. Your time limit for copyright is 70 to 170 year, but here it is given that life of author plus 70 year. So it can also be written as life of author plus 70 year, or we can say that 170 year approx. For patent it is 15 to 20 years. So, or we can say that directly 20 years from filing. For trademark, it is indefinite, or we also say that 10 years of increment. There is a 10 years of increments here. 10 years of increment for every trademark. And for copyright, fair use, for patent, no fair use, no research exemption, and for trademark, also fair use. So these are some important difference between copyright, patent, and trademark. Now there is the important term plagiarism. What is plagiarism? Plagiarism is using another person's ideas in your writing without giving credit to that person, or in simple word we can say that stealing information from someone else, or stealing some intellectual work, or stealing information of someone else is called the plagiarism. So in other words, plagiarism is a copying information and not giving the author's credit for it. So it is called the plagiarism, and it is basically a crime. And this is the detailed definition of plagiarism. Plagiarism is an act of stealing someone else's creativity, ideas, or language, and it is considered to be cheating and a corrupt act. Second point, as I told you earlier, that it is basically cheating or corrupt act. And third point is, in advanced countries with high standards of education, plagiarism is considered to be an academic crime. But in some country, undeveloped countries, it like Cambodia, it often goes unnoticed. So plagiarism is there are some three important points. First is that stealing information of regarding to creative work or some ideas is basically a plagiarism. Second point is, it is a cheating or a corrupt act. Third important thing is that in most of the country it is considered as academic crime, but in most undeveloped countries like Cambodia, it often goes unnoticed. Now let us take the definition of plagiarism again. So now we can see that plagiarism is using and the person's ideas in your writing without giving credit to that person, or plagiarism is copying information and not giving the author credit for it. If you steal someone's creative work and not give credit to his or her, then it is called plagiarism. Now there is a clear description about plagiarism. Plagiarism is basically are of two type. First one is deliberate plagiarism and second is accidental plagiarism. So deliberate plagiarism, intentional plagiarism, or accidental is by default or without even the person who perform the activity of plagiarism doesn't know that he perform a serious crime. So what is deliberate plagiarism? Rewriting from books or articles. So it is a deliberate plagiarism because it is done by deliberately. It is done deliberately. And second point is copying and pasting from web pages and online source to create patchwork writing. It is also a plagiarism. And buying, downloading, or borrowing a paper is also a plagiarism. So these are all the deliberately plagiarism. And accidental plagiarism include, first point is not knowing when and how to cite. Second point, not knowing how to paraphrase or summarize. And third point, not knowing what common knowledge is. And last point is recycling and old paper. So there are two types of plagiarism: deliberate and accidental. Accidental is by default and deliberate is intentional or intentionally when someone performs a serious crime like plagiarism, then it is called a deliberate plagiarism. And why it is a very serious? Because it is an act of stealing someone's ideas without giving credit to him, without giving credit. So this is a plagiarism. Now in this lecture there are some few important points which we discuss, and these points are intellectual property right, and in intellectual property there are some other points, some important points such as patent, copyright and trademark. And at last we read about or we learn about plagiarism. So let us take a quick revision or to the point definition of these terms. So what is intellectual property? Intellectual property is a property created by the application of human mind, and it is related to textiles, cosmetics, pharmaceuticals, machineries, etc. Second is, intellectual property are basically categorized into two basic categories: industrial properties and copyright. And there are many types of intellectual property rights. Some of them are patent, copyright, trademarks, design, database and trade secrets. And copyright protects someone who creates an original work. That is why it is called a copyright. Next, copyright is related to literary, dramatic, musical, artistic and architectural work. There's a example of licensing, and copyright basically allows authors, musicians, artists to make money off of their labor. Patent is an exclusive right, and it is basically used for an invention, and it is used for a limited period of time. These are the three important things. First, exclusive right, used for an invention. Third, and used for a limited period of time. And here, first line is very important. Patent is a property right granted to the inventor by the patent office, and the time limit is 17 to 20 years. And what is trademark? Trademark is basically a distinctive sign which identifies the goods and service of one company from those of another. For example, we can see that for Coca-Cola there is a trademark here, and for Nike there is also a trademark. And trademark for basically used for customer, and because customer trust that the company makes good products. And there are some important points which shows the difference between copyright, patent and trademark. Copyright protect expression, not ideas, and patent protect ideas that have been reduced to practice, and trademark protect goods, goodwill associated with mark. Protect goods will associated with marks. And for time limit, copyright, it is life of author plus 70 years and approximately 70 years, and for patent it is 20 years, and for trademark 10 years of increment, and it is actually infinite or indefinite time. Actually indefinite time, not infinite time. Indefinite time, but there is increment of 10 years. So these are the some important, and the example of copyright of music, art and photography. And for patent, it is basically used for medical devices or some technologies. And example of trademarks are words, logos and slogans. And plagiarism, what is plagiarism? It's stealing of someone's information and without giving credit to her or him or his, without giving credit to him, then this is called the plagiarism. And second thing is regarding the plagiarism, that it is a cheating or a corrupt act, and in some countries it is considered academic crime, but in some undeveloped countries it is not as considered as academic crime, like Cambodia. And there are two types of plagiarism: deliberate plagiarism and accidental plagiarism. And these are the some difference between these two. What are the different types of deliberate plagiarism, and what are the different types of accidental plagiarism? Now I hope these terms are now quite clear to all of you. Thank you for watching this video.